Okay. After, sorry that, the start of this is a little different, but, for some reason my game was crashing a lot on startup when I was starting from this idle. So, I think the way to alleviate that is to not start up at this idle once I, do the next segment. Now, for this segment, it's actually going to be a shorter one. There are a few things that we can do now that we weren't able to do before, and we're just gonna go and do them. So first thing is, we are gonna go to the old grave. And run past these guys. And let's have, where are you? You. Dive. See, there's a headless. Fight this headless. Ow. Can we, like, not guard? That was tougher than I thought it was going to be. Why are my frames dropping so hard? Thank you. actually has a really tough time recovering from the attacks here. Ugo Spirit Fall. Ooh. Headless are the ruined form of corrupted heroes who once fought for their country. This warrior lost his mind in defense of the state. His attempted mutiny was met with a swift beheading and the lifeless body sunk to the bottom of the moat. Heavy coin purse. Another heavy coin purse. And another heavy coin purse. Yashiriku. God, the frames. Part of it is I'm editing part 15, I think, right now. And I should probably not be doing that. Anyway, let's use the Homeward Idol now that we have those three. Whatchamacallit, those three, those three heavy coin purses. God, I can't really speak today. Yeah, holy shit. Oh? What's Emma doing here? Actually, no, I can't. Isn't she supposed to be with Ishin?
Omae-san mo kita no ka? Washi wa
Oh, wait a minute. I'm an idiot. I need to use the fucking heavy coin purses first. Here we are. Actually, yeah, Phoenix's Lilac Umbrella. That'll actually help me out greatly. And then we need to get more scrap iron for the Spiral Spear. And Fulminated Mercury. From what I've gathered, in that Toxic Pit, there's the Toxic Pit, meaning the one right before the Guardian Ape. There's apparently Fulminated Mercury in there. I didn't even need the third one. Shit. Oh well. Now the next place we're gonna go to... is the poison pool. And you notice how there was one specific idol that was blanked out. Yeah, so not only does the Headless Ape make its home there. Oh shit, I fucked up. Not only does the Headless Ape make its home there, but after you beat him, there's another person. Other person is who we're about to fight right now, and he's pretty weak to Phoenix's Lilac Umbrella.
Oh.
the same time, we need modeled purple gourd, purifying agent, and divine confetti. Now I hope after this we have enough divine confetti for the final thing we need to do, which is another headless. He still talks about the ape. But yeah, there's another Shichimin warrior here. So we gotta kick its ass. So if I do that one shinobi art skill with the Phoenix Lilac Umbrella, it basically acts as if I have divine confetti, which is pretty cool. I didn't want to get overwhelmed with terror. Oh shit. There we are. Owl Contents Ring. An old ring well suited for slender fingers. Keen fissures engraved on the other side can be used to upgrade the finger whistle prosthetic tool. Wearing this ring as you blow the finger whistle will create a somber tune. The weeping voice is full of solitude and beauty, possibly somber enough to temporarily quell a voice of rage. Shit. Well, that's cool. And now we can reclaim this idol once again. Now the last one... No, not here. Should be this one right here at the end of Shrine Valley. Should be one final headless fight. Or not one final, but it's gonna be the fourth of five? I have never seen... this kind of night terror before. That was weird. Now, I need to double check on the location of this. Oh, wait a minute, I'm going the wrong way. That explains why I felt a little off. So from the sculptor's idol... Speaking of which, I'm just gonna go back to it with this. So from here, turn around. Go back this way. Alright. Now... A floating passage might still be useful. But I think Whirlwind Slash is just the better one overall. That is annoying. clock. And, oh my god. I need a rest anyway. Those are a pretty good source of farming, though. 620 XP piece. Get across this area. You have to go towards the end of that cave, but I'm only gonna do that once I rest again. Basically, what we're gonna do right now is just go back so that we rest, and then jumped a little bit too far away. I kind of want to beat them anyway, because I'm so close to leveling up. Yeah, if I beat them again, then I'll get another skill point. Oh, I fucking got that Mikiri counter. Come on. I'm gonna defeat you, get my fucking skill point, and then I'm just here. Yep. And now I'm gonna go back, and I'm gonna do what I was originally gonna do, which is just fucking skip past fuckers. But should be able to at least get something with these two skill points. I could get vault over. Nightjar slash. And that's it. Or I could save up for Emma's medicine aroma. That way I could basically just pretty much insta-heal myself with every sip of the gourd. Which that might not be a bad idea. Or I could save it for suppressed sound, Shinobi's mind, Shinobi's karma mind, or even midair combat arts. Which, yeah, I might go with that because that'll only increase it by one. Anyway. Probably have to use a pellet, maybe? When we were originally over here, it was like, there's no way this could only be it. I completely forgot that, that this was an actual lake. Now you can dive in here. Now where's... a pellet. Can't use a pellet while underwater. Somehow use gourds while underwater, but not pellets. Should be a way to grapple up. Or at least get up. If there's... yeah, no. There's gotta be some gravel point or some ledge. Thank you. But yeah, you can see, like, the headless right over there. I feel like an idiot right now. How the fuck do you get up? I know that does nothing. I need to figure this out real quick. Oh, I'm a moron. Duh. So, you know that beautiful thing you could do up along a wall? It's called a wall kick. Duh. I'm a fucking moron. Alright, so. Divine confetti. That. Ow. How? How did I gain that much terror? Divine confetti. Ow. Oh my god, I can't sprint. There we go. Yeah. Spirit Fall. Fallen Headless Spirit of Gokon reduces posture taken, damage taken for a time. Headless are the ruined form of corrupted heroes who once fought for their country. Dedicated burial mounds quietly appease the spirits with severed heads, though none call upon them for long. And what else was down here? Lump of grave wax. Interesting. And a divine grass. Hell yeah. Alright, so from here, this is where this segment is going to end. What I'm going to do is I'm going to grind until I get, well, I might as well show you. I'm going to grind until I can get all of the possible all the possible shinobi prosthetic upgrades. And the reason why I feel like this is doable is because of how much XP and sen the new enemies give you. So by that I mean Spiral Spear is absolutely happening. I'm grinding for that. In fact, all I need is just a bit of scrap iron. The only tricky thing is going to be Fulminated Mercury. I definitely want to grind for Malcontent since I have all the materials for it. I'm not sure if there's a way to farm Lump of Grave Wax. I'm not entirely sure what other one I'm going to go for if I can't get more Grave Wax. Because I know I need three for... You know what? Actually, no, that makes it easy then. So then Malcontent, and I'll try to get Golden Vortex. And after that, what else was I gonna grind for? Oh, I'm definitely grinding for that green gourd that the toxic memorial mob sells. Now I'm gonna see if it's possible to get pretty much all the way up to these last four. Other than probably the Great Feather Mistraven, because I don't have enough grave wax. Though I do know that it's this material right here that prevents you from just being able to get every single shinobi prosthetic in your first run. So anyway, I'm going to try to get as many shinobi prosthetics as I possibly can, as well as get the green gourd that is sold in the bottom of this valley. And just in case if you want to be reminded of what that is, I'm gonna go to it. Oh yeah, that person has dragon rot. I forgot about that. Poor person. Unfortunately. So basically what I'm talking about, this guy right here, gold. He sells the green mossy gourd. It said green mossy gourd is pretty damn good against enemies who poison you. And I kind of wish I had it against the guardian ape. And some of the lone shadow mini bosses definitely make you feel like it would be amazing if you had it. And yeah, that's about it for this segment.
Shut up.
So yeah, this is Maximus signing out. Have a good one. Hey, this is Maximus here. One last thing I forgot to do in that one part. And I didn't really want to add it to the next segment, because the next segment kind of deserves to have what we're going to tackle be like the sole focus of it. We need to talk to Doujun. Not Doujun. I don't remember this guy's name. Doujun? Yeah, we need to talk to Doujun. Okay. Oh, fuck. You can't get out of this. It just does a shit ton of damage to you. Now, into here, down there, kill you both. Like coin purse, three of them. Ceramic shard. Dosaku's note. My disciples have abandoned me for Doujun. Unwilling to dirty their own hands, they all left me for that hypocritical quack. Doujun, my last disciple, even if I die, the research must continue. Finish the procedure for Ashina's sake. I believe you have to, like, let that thing progress. And by progress, I mean, like, go and rest at a idol. Also, we don't have much use for divine confetti anymore. Other than, like, I think one last headless monster. And maybe a few things. I unfortunately wasted quite a bit of it at the monk. I mean, that was really unnecessary. I'm just gonna put a hidden tooth on. And I'm gonna need to get out of that one area. Or get out of a Discord. Also, I think they're trying to insinuate that Doujun and Dosaku are pretty much the same person.
Oh,
使うというのですか。もう、お主は、なぜか。お、おやめください。やはりこれは、もはや井戸からは外れております。何故このようなことを。
Because you can't see anyone else.
See,
like, you come in here. Nobody's around other than Doujun. Also, when Doujun got Dragon Rot, I kind of skipped past the description of the Rot Essence, but Rot Essence Surgeon said that both of them coughed at once. Which leads me to believe that it could be a split personality disorder. Don't know where to go at this point. Maybe this guy? Yeah, no, he doesn't say shit. Now my question is, where do I go now? Do I rest again? Yeah, I'm not sure where to go at this point. I think it's somewhere in the abandoned dungeon. Oh, hi! So I have to fight you now. So he fights just like the samurai. which means, what should I grab? Pellet? Probably Ungo's Hidden Tooth, yeah. Don't really need too many items for this. I meant to fucking jump. It's got quite a bit of posture. Let's do Ichimonchi double. Yeah, Sparking Axe would probably be the best for this. Maybe Long Spark? Doesn't burn. That's good to know. Ooh. The pellet saved my life, and then he just trapped me in here. He has so much posture. It's not even that it regenerates. It's that there's just so much of it. Really? Fucking shit. Oh, I somehow got unseen. Thank Christ.
Good.
Buy that, at the very least.
Jeez.
But now that I know what I'm dealing with, this should be a tad easier. Also, I should just commune with that idol. Oh shit, now they're both there? He fights like a monk. This is bad. So they don't burn easily. Which means flame vent or the sparking axe, or well, mostly the flame vent's not gonna be useful. My god. Supposed to take on both of them at the same time on this tiny island? They just completely destroyed my... They just destroyed my guard. I wonder if there's a way to sneak up on one of them. I just lost 2,000 XP. Fucking shit, man. I wonder if I could sneak up on them. Maybe. You can't be serious. Well, that was helpful. Doujun. Oh, he died. He only gives me 240. Academics red lump. This is the thing that we were basically looking for. A round red lump found inside the body of red-eyed Doujun. Assumed to gain red eyes and reduce flinching from enemy attacks, but also prohibits the use of resurrection. Busaku and Doujun were the quintessential master disciple. Often when pursuing the ideal self, one need only look within. Yeah, I think they try to imply heavily that Dosaku and Doujun were the same person. That. All right, I've still got a resurrection though. Come on! I somehow got unseen aid, at least. Yeah, so at least Doujun is dead. But that guy... Out. least you can always go into the water if you need to use the healing board. I forgot, I don't have mid-air combat arts. I can't move! There we are. What do you drop? Oh, it's just a red lump. 58. I don't know how much XP he gave me. Anyway, that's the end of Doujun's questline. Which was the one thing that I really wanted to show. So, hopefully I remember to edit that into the previous part. Now, I could also show, when it came to fulminated mercury, there is a bit of a problem. So, the way I got my first fulminated mercury, which is the only one that I have, by the way, I went over here to Bod Vista Valley. Go down here. Really? I still took fall damage even though I interrupted it? If that... I'm a fucking moron! Man, I am so damn good. Like, I am so damn good at this game. Yeah, and I just lost 180, so now I can't actually buy that mossy green gourd. Yeah, what am I doing? Should've just done that first. So yeah, you go down here. Fuck all of this shit. Kill him for XP, I guess, if you want. I don't know how much sin he actually gives you. I actually don't remember going up here, though. Yeah, that just puts you back on the normal path. I thought I would be able to grapple to that. And I just missed? I am really bad at this game. I just saved myself there. Alright. So, you see the toxic memorial mob right there. Grab onto that. Pass that over there. Now, there are a bunch of monkeys over here. They don't have it. It's behind this rock right here. Now that I've done that, I'm getting the fuck out of here. Ow? Wow, that monkey dropped yellow gunpowder? Seriously? They're doing okay signs. That Buddha statue had okay hand signs. Alright. And the other way that I've been told to get fulminated mercury, or at least in order to be able to get it early, is go to you remember that bell that we found at Senpo Temple, but it was from when we went, I don't remember, yeah, Bell Demon's Temple. Ringing this bell apparently gives you a better chance of dropped items, which is going to be heavily needed if we're going to try to get any more fulminated mercury before we move on to, like, endgame stuff. Which apparently we're pretty close by. So let's ring this shit. Sinister Burden. Bell Demon. Demonic spirit sealed within the iron bell of Senpo Temple. Possesses those who ring the bell, strengthening enemies around them. The Bell Demon confers hardship, but perhaps also slightly better spoils. Using this item has no particular effect aside from causing the demon to leave. So I guess if you use the Bell Demon, then you get rid of it. Now the next thing to do is go to Sunken Valley Gunfort. And then whatever balloon allows you to get better drops. Which I believe is Mibu Possession Balloon. You're going to want to use that. Ideally, you also would want at least Virtuous Deed. And I think there's another one, probably up there. That's pretty much the same as Virtuous Deed, but just stacks onto it. But since I don't have that, we're just gonna keep going with this. Now, yeah, it is this way. And then just keep backstabbing this fucker. Hey, first try. And then just rest and just rinse and repeat. It's still a pretty rare drop otherwise. Yeah, like this time I only got antidote powder. And then just keep doing this until the balloon runs out, and then use the balloon again and repeat, rinse and repeat. Yep, only antidote powder again. Yep, antidote powder again. Damn. You can also do this at the poison pool. But, it's really just personal preference. Both of them are the same kind of enemy. They have the same kind of drop rate, apparently. That one didn't even... he didn't even drop an item that time. Beautiful. But yeah, they have a chance of dropping a specific item. But then they have a chance on top of that of dropping... that determines what item they drop. Two black gunpowders. Item balloon is lasting a while. I thought it was only gonna last... Okay, it finally ran out. I thought it was only gonna last, like, 4 or 5 times. That's why I was recording this part as well. Anyway, so now that I've shown you that, at the very least, now I'm actually going to do some grinding. Going to purchase that mossy green gourd, and then after that, I'm going to keep grinding until I get, till I can get whatever prosthetic tools I can. If I don't get enough fulminated mercury to make a shit ton of prosthetic tools, then I'll just use whatever I have on whatever I have and then progress with the game, because it's not worth just grinding my entire life away just to be able to get all that stuff before the end game. And let me go and use those real quick, then use those real quick. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Hope you all enjoyed. This is Maximus signing out. Have a good one.